I'm Anna, the CEO and co-founder of Korion Health and a joint medical PhD student. 2 years ago, I met a patient who changed my life. He came in for chest pain that had gone untreated for years and finally become unbearable. Turns out he had heart failure and was told to return every few weeks for monitoring. But like so many people, my patient faced barriers making it into the clinic, which he couldn't overcome. Telemedicine was doing great, but we can't reach through a screen to listen to someone's heart. And without monitoring, I worried he could lose his life. So I made him a promise that if he kept showing up, I would find him a better solution. And that promise became Korion Health. As a second-year med student, I 3D printed an electronic stethoscope so my patient could get these critical exams from home. A light allows it to be visible under a shirt, maximizing sound quality from direct skin contact while still preserving privacy, and a guided interface accessible on your phone or your laptop uses AI to ensure the stethoscope is placed correctly every time, enabling anyone to get these screenings remotely with the same accuracy as a clinic visit. This augments the remote exam and increases patient reach for telemedicine companies. So we sell to them in bulk, and then they include our device in existing kits sent to patients for home health monitoring. We will leverage these initial partnerships to build out product validation and data analytics, after which it becomes more interesting to consumers. So we will expand B2C through a combination of e-commerce and retailers, with a subscription for people to store and track their health data. Validating this approach are 5 LOIs from telemedicine companies and consumer surveys showing high interest. In just 5 years, we will scale to the point of seeing a measurable reduction in ER visits from heart failure, saving hospitals millions of dollars and impacting an Olympic stadium's worth of lives. These are based on existing partnerships, but the digital health market in the US and abroad is orders of magnitude larger, leaving plenty of room to grow. While there are other electronic stethoscopes on the market, existing ones are either only for clinicians or too expensive for most consumers. Ours is not only the most affordable, it is the only one with an interactive guided interface to guarantee accurate use by laypersons. And don't just take our word for it. Community members invited to test the device consistently rate it a 9 out of 10 for usability. And that's because we deeply understand the patient experience from all angles. I have a background in the trifecta of engineering, medicine, and policy, and Akshaya just graduated with her machine learning degree and is an award-winning healthcare innovator. But more than that, we are both the children of immigrants and have been patients and patient advocates our whole lives. We know how scary it is to fall through the cracks, and we're building this so others don't have to feel that way. We are advised by leaders in digital health, including Walgreens, the US Department of Veterans Affairs, and DoxyMe, the world's largest telemedicine platform. And together, we get things done. We have built a robust pipeline to reach patients while working with design and manufacturing partners to turn my 3D print into an actually fully functional prototype that people can use. And the start-to-finish solution is protected by our company-owned omnibus patent. The next step is to get FDA clearance so we can execute on these LOIs and reach our first patients, for which we'll need around $1.7 million. Of that, we've raised almost half through a combination of grants, crowdfunding, and foundations, including having support from the American Heart Association. And the Hult Prize would be the last step we need to making this dream reality. I will end on this sobering statistic. Heart and lung disease remain the leading causes of death worldwide. In the 4 minutes I have been talking, 200 people lost their lives from these conditions, and most of those deaths were preventable through early screenings. In the next 4 minutes, you can change that by investing in Korion and joining us on our mission of making preventable heart disease a thing of the past. Thank you.
Congratulations, Korion Health. I'd like to now give it to the judges for follow-up questions.
How many vital signs do you need to take in order to diagnose heart and lung disease, and how many is your device picking up?
That's a great question. So when you typically go to the doctor's office, they'll do a physical exam that takes your temperature, your blood pressure, and everything in your body is connected, right? If you have heart disease and your heart isn't pumping oxygen to the rest of your body, that can affect other organs, even your circulation, or especially your circulation. So our goal long-term is actually to take the typical primary care visit basically everything I'm learning in medical school and convert it into a simple kit that people can use at home to get these exams.
Do you see these things selling in a Walmart or somewhere else the way a blood pressure medicine machine would work?
Yeah, so we do see comparable devices already being sold in places like Walgreens, et cetera, and we would add our kit into that same location that patients are already comfortable getting these home health monitoring devices.
So the follow-up question is that reportable immediately to a doctor? And if they don't have a doctor, what do they do with the information?
Yeah, so the current paradigm that we have right now is we allow patients to download their own data and then share it with their physicians either through uploading on a patient portal. With the rise of telehealth, many physician offices have implemented patient portals, and that is now becoming standard practice. If a patient does not have a primary care physician, how do we reach them, right? We have abilities in the future to offer diagnostics that will provide patients with feedback immediately after they conduct their exam.
Is there any competition from wearables? Because I think a lot of the wearables, you know, track some of these things like heart monitors and so on.
Yeah, as a resident medical student, I will take this one. So wearables like the Apple Watch can only measure things such as like your heart rate or pulse oximetry. But the reason that we listen to the heart every time is because we listen to all four heart valves. So we're checking the health of every valve. And that is something that you cannot listen to on a wearable because it's just too blunt force of a hammer to look at it with. You really need to have the location correct. You need to have the pressure correct. And I don't see a way of doing that with like a wearable watch. I guess you could do a wearable pulse stethoscope, but that sounds kind of uncomfortable.
Good pitch. How do you divide the roles between the two of you?
So I take on most of the operationals and technical development, and then Anna does lead the clinical fundraising and partnership side.
Yeah, I do have a background of engineering from undergrad, but I kind of know enough to be dangerous and know it's possible. I can't actually implement it, so I'm very grateful to have Ikshire for that side.
Yeah, given how competitive the remote monitoring space is already, how do you plan to target the market? Are you going to go a specific clinical application or primary care, heart failure?
Yeah, so we're actually entering in the market through pediatric telehealth. We're partnering with a company that we already have a letter of intent with. They will be using this, parents will use this to record their heart and lungs of the kids.
Yeah, I mean, the goal, of course, in the long term is to expand, but we can't boil the ocean, right? So we're taking it in stages. Actually, one of my college friends works within one of the biggest pediatric telemedicine companies, and he came to me shortly after I started this project asking if we had a stethoscope, because they have many kids with asthma whose symptoms flare up at night, and their patients or their parents don't have any way to know when they should take them to an emergency room. So that's actually one of our first use cases. Stethoscopes are used ubiquitously, though, and have many applications, but we have to start somewhere. So that's why we're using these initial partnerships to build the product validation and have the data to build the analytics, and then we can continue expanding.
Yeah, and I would just like to add that, like you mentioned, it is a crowded space. The home health monitoring market is valued at $30 billion. The greater telehealth market, $300 billion. Our closest competitors are not making anywhere near that market. There's a lot of space for us to grow and take a piece of that.
Thank you, Korion Health.